just here for the 120 degree heat over August, and that didn't change. It still happened. So you'll see that I'm just kind of passing this through a sieve. What's happening is we want that to be nice and smooth. If you don't have this at home, you can use like a cocktail strainer, or you can use like a chinois, or if you might just have like a simple colander, anything to just kind of capture. I don't know if you can we see this. Yes. Just to capture some of these particles that didn't blend as finely. So we just get a nice, smooth puree. So what we're left with, as I said, is this bright, beautiful, clean, luscious orange, yellow sauce. We'll taste that just to make sure that we have enough salt. Pretty delicious. You have it in front of you, so hopefully you're enjoying it as much as I just did. So now that we've kind of gotten through our sauce, we can let the flavors kind of meld and marinate in this. And we'll transition over into our red onion. So we're just going to do a simple chop on this. And the way that I like to chop an onion to get a nice fine dice is you just take the top off. And then from there, if you look at the onion, you can see it's got these little rings running through it. So if you take your knife and you just stop right at the bulb, you can come back through one more time. Bigger onions, take a couple more slices. And then from there, we're going to segment the onion this way. So then it's all held together by its little bulb piece, so that when we go back through to finish it, our dice is all the same size. It's very important to kind of clean as you go. So as you saw, once I finished all my measured ingredients, I just kind of got rid of the containers that they were in. So we keep our workspace nice and clean. Another way, and again, this is, cooking isn't really about, you know, following a recipe to its exact T. Once you kind of get comfortable with it, kind of take advantage of, you know, tweaking it to your liking. You're going to see there's sweet potatoes in here. Maybe you don't like sweet potatoes. Maybe use a purple potato. Peru is known for their potatoes. They have hundreds of different kinds of potatoes. So if you choose to not go with the sweet potato I mentioned, there's nothing wrong with it. The other thing you can do is if you're like, man, I'm just not a huge fan of raw onion. I get it. I used to be that way too. So what you can do instead, especially if you're planning ahead because you know you have a cocktail party coming up, you can come in and you can julienne this onion, get a different cut on it. Once you get to the top, just kind of roll it over and you'll finish coming through on that. And you can prep these onions ahead of time. And what we'll do is it's called a lime, like a pickled onion with lime juice. So you just kind of break it apart a little bit. And I also started with this early because I wanted to show you this other kind of like pro tip or like technique that I like to use. So you'll add a little bit of salt. What the salt is going to do is it's actually going to take a lot of that water out of the onion. And that water that we're extracting is that like kind of raw onion flavor. So we can kind of like soften the blow, so to speak. And then I'll finish by grabbing a fresh lime, cut it in half, and just kind of squeezed it over the top. And as that kind of marinates, you'll see the color change. And it'll turn this beautiful bright red, as you can probably see in your ceviche if you have any left. It just takes a lime or a lime and a half. And as it breaks down, I prefer to do this overnight. If you're, like I said, if you're planning ahead, as that breaks down, it just kind of softens it up and just kind of adds a really nice different texture. So we've got our onion, we've got our aji amarillo sauce. The last component that I don't have ready is the cucumber, because I really wanted to talk to you about like my favorite type of cucumber. It's a Persian cucumber. I don't know if anyone's familiar with them, but they are a little bit more, they're a lot more flavorful. They have smaller seeds, and they're just a more delicate ingredient. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to scrape this onion, as we have on our recipe, into our mixing bowl. And we'll discard the rest. Just wanted you to see the process of dicing an onion. And then we'll move into our cucumber. So these cucumbers, when I open it up, you'll see the difference from like a traditional like hothouse or, you know, just bulk cucumber. Why do I peel it? The skin actually is kind of like, it's a different texture, and I like to have it be soft. And it also has like a, you know, that it's that different color, and the skin is actually even a little bit bitter. So when you peel that off, and then the same thing with the seeds actually have a little bittering agent to them. So we're gonna peel these seeds out. And then from there, just dice it. So if you see these seeds, they're really, really, really small, really fine. They're not going to be as bitter or as abrasive as like a full-size cucumber if you choose to not go that extra step to remove them. And then the same thing, the easier way to get a uniform dice on a cucumber, cut it in half, get it in more manageable sizes and pieces. And just do the same thing. We're not doing a whole lot of cooking here. What we're really doing is just combining flavors. And the most important part to kind of have that restaurant quality dish is to just focus on making sure you're as consistent as possible. Because if you're trying to show off for your friends, as much as they won't tell you, you know, we're all judging each other. I mean, come on, let's be real here. We're still friends. We'll never say it, but it happens. So we'll move through and we'll dice this cucumber. And we just need a little bit more to hit the amount that we need for this recipe. I don't know if you noticed, but at the restaurant we have this ceviche on our menu also, and your ceviche was served in a scallop shell. So we actually bring them in from the East Coast where these scallops are harvested. We clean them up, we get them all nice and pretty, and then that's what we serve the dish in. So it just kind of adds that, like, for me, I think it's a wow factor, you know? It's unique, it's different, it's its own. You're eating a ceviche of an animal in its own shell. You know, pretty cool. So now that we have our cucumber, we're gonna add the rest of our components. So we have the sweet potato. I just went ahead and steamed the sweet potato. I like to steam the sweet potato because it keeps, again, you know, we're eating something raw, so we're trying to, you know, in theory, hopefully it's healthy, right? So we are, you know, by steaming the potato, it keeps a little bit more of that nutrition factor in. We also have some shaved and julienned radish. These radishes are local from the Coachella Valley. We picked them up from our date farmer that we purchased all of our dates from for the restaurant at Z's Farms. And so we have all of our ingredients in here right now. We're gonna add a little bit of salt because we season everything. And then we will go in and pour in our liquid before we add our scallops. We're gonna let this marinate while we prepare our cilantro, because herbs are delicious. They're one of my best friends. I moved out here from San Diego. Prior to that, I was in Kalamazoo, Michigan, so I didn't really deal with a whole lot of freshness in Michigan. You know, it's very cold. It's basically the polar opposite of where I live now. But once I moved to San Diego and I just dealt with all these different vibrant flavors and cuisines, I really learned to appreciate herbs and like what they bring to the table and how much, you know, how much more important it is to use something fresh than to use something, you know, dried. But it also depends on, you know, when you choose to incorporate it. That's why we're incorporating the cilantro into our recipe last, because we want it to maintain its freshness and we don't want it to break down. The cilantro is also local from Aziz Farms. So if you're new to the area or you want to check out it's a cool opportunity, Aziz Farms down in Temecula, they grow a ton of dates. We partner with them. We receive produce from them every week, and they just do such a great job. So I like to bunch up my cilantro because we're just going to go in and try and mince it. And another thing that a lot of people don't really realize is that there's just as much flavor in the cilantro stem. So if you are a cilantro lover, some of you are, some of you think it tastes like soap. But if you really love it, you can incorporate some of those cilantro stems into your amarillo sauce as well to, again, just add like a different layer of flavor and texture. So we'll sprinkle in our cilantro, fold this all together. And the trick to this is to serve it fairly quickly. You don't only want it to sit for more than 10, maybe 15 minutes. You know, the Peruvians, they've been eating ceviche for thousands of years. You know, they didn't have citrus. Citrus was brought to the Americas by Christopher Columbus. So before then, they would use, you know, fruits and vegetables that they had local to, you know, their environment. And they would ferment them to get that acidity, because you still need that acidity to produce the results that when you don't have citrus. So here's our ceviche. I'm going to let it sit for about 5 minutes and just kind of give you a little bit of background about me. You know, like I said, I moved out here. I'm the chef at Trio. We are a local restaurant. We've been open for about 13 years now. And, you know, we're really trying to kind of keep the ball moving forward. I started in October, and, you know, hopefully we can do great things together and keep this, you know, Palm Springs food movement rolling forward. It's just nice to be in a different environment, in a different scene. I've got two kids, and the desert is a much better area to raise kids than downtown San Diego, let me tell you. So for serving this, I like to just keep it simple. Just grab it, nice bowl, big platter. It's perfect for serving on a hot day. Did we like it? Everyone's so quiet, I'm not really sure. The cool thing about, like I mentioned with cooking earlier, is that, you know, there's really no rules. Like, all cooking really is science. So, like, if you want to go in and you want to change, you can completely flip this on its side and turn it into, you know, a Japanese dish and use, like, yuzu kosho. I don't know if you're familiar with that. It's like a fermented chili paste. And then you can use, you know, citrus and soy sauce. You'll get the same consistency in sauce. It may not be the same color, but it's just a way to change it on its side. You can do fresh snapper. You can do shrimp if you're a little bit more traditional, you know. But the beauty is that ceviche didn't start in Mexico. Ceviche started in Peru, and that's why I really wanted to highlight a Peruvian ceviche. The most important component, in my opinion, to a good ceviche is freshly fried chips. Frying chips at home, if you're gonna take that initiative, it can be a little scary at first. One trick that I would just say is you just want to get a nice big pot, fill it with oil, and if you want to aim to fry them at about 350 degrees. So initially, when you're using at home, likely a thermometer, most of us probably don't have a tabletop deep fryer. Is you want to heat your oil up to 375 degrees, because as you add your cold tortilla chips in, your oil temperature is going to come down. And when your oil temperature comes down, if it comes down too low, your chips will start absorbing the oil instead of expelling their water to get crispy. So you end up with soggy, oily chips, and nobody wants that. Does anyone have any questions? You can find it on Amazon. They sell it in this size. They sell it in this size. And then they even have the Amazonas brand, which is one of my favorites. All of them work really well. And like I mentioned, our partnership with Aziz Farms, they're actually going to be growing me these peppers fresh, since it's starting to warm up here. So I'm going to be able to use fresh Aji Amarillo peppers, among many other beautiful produce and vegetables. Mark just started growing about a year ago and servicing the restaurants this year. So looking to, you know, kind of give him a run for his money on, you know, finding some unique things to use that, you know, you can't really get anywhere. Question, yeah. I mean, it's really, you know, it really depends on the freshest of the fish. So you need to rely a lot on your senses. So like when you're purchasing, I would suggest Whole Foods. You know, they usually have a pretty strong seafood program. And you want to, I'm sorry, no frozen. I prefer fresh. You can use frozen, but you want to make sure that you thaw it overnight, not in running water, so it kind of lets off all of its own all of its own liquid, and then you want to pat it dry. And it's still good to use like that too. About 5 minutes, you know, maybe 10 minutes. But again, if you're using a fresh product, you can eat it right away. Like I would have no problem just going in and eating this right now. I'm sorry. You can use whatever you want. You can use lime. You need to use something that's a little bit kind of acidic. So you need like lime or lemon, because you need it to kind of break down the, again, cooking is science. So like we're using the lime or the acid to break down the cellular structure of the onion so that it releases that those noxious like flavors that some of us don't find appealing. And the salt also helps with that because it extracts liquid. But the world is your oyster. You know, that's the beauty of cooking. You know, cooking is your oyster too. And you can enjoy this sauce with oysters as well. It's nice and bright and vibrant. Any other questions? I wish we were doing some more cooking because I'm not sure if I took up all my time, but I'm good. Okay, cool. But I just wanted to serve you something that is kind of really home to my heart in moving out here from San Diego. So, thank you. Thanks for joining us at Palm Springs or Palm Desert Food and Wine Festival too. It's been a great experience. It's my first time and it certainly won't be my last. So I hope to see you again next year. Cheers.